Let's register the master data for the mold injection manufacturing process and create a finite capacity schedule. Scheduling that takes into account production capacity, production quantity, and manufacturing equipment load requires information such as item processes and production capacity. Scheduling becomes possible when this information is registered to the integrated master editor table and the manufacturing orders for the items to be manufactured are registered. Final item product 1 is manufactured by assembling molded parts component 1 and component 2. First, let's register the integrated master for component 1. Component 1 being a molded product, it is manufactured using an injection molding machine and a mold. As no integrated master and item have been registered yet, component 1 is the first item. When component 1 is registered to the integrated master table, it is also automatically added to the item table. Component 1 is manufactured using an injection process. We register injection molding machine injection as the manufacturing equipment. The production capacity of injection is 15 minutes per piece. Further, mold 1 is also required for injection molding. Because mold 1 is used while set in the injection molding machine, we make it dependent on the production time of injection. At this time, the resource used for calculating the production time is set as the main resource. Since the production time is determined by the production time of injection molding machine injection, we make injection the main resource. We register mold 1 as a sub-resource. These resources are also registered to the resource table. If the process requires workers, we would also register workers. This is explained in detail in a later video, so we will not register workers here. This completes the creation of the integrated master for component 1. During operation, this integrated master can be imported from the database used to manage items and integrated master or from an external system. Here, let's register also component 2 and product 1 in order to better understand the registration method. Next, let's register the part component 2. Component 2 being the same molded part as component 1, the process is similar. So let's copy and edit the data that was registered for component 1. Component 2 uses a different mold than that for component 1, so we change the mold to mold 2. The production capacity is 10 minutes per piece. In the case of molds, this is the number of cavities, but I will explain this in detail in a later video. Lastly, let's register the integrated master for product 1. We input the two parts, component 1 and component 2. At this time, let's set a separate instruction code for each. An instruction code is like a group, so only one is adopted when multiple instances of the same instruction code exist. Here, we want to input a separate instruction code for each of component 1 and component 2. So we register the instruction codes as IN1 and IN2. The assembly process is performed using a type of equipment called assembly. It can assemble one product in 1 minute. We have now registered the integrated master for 3 items. Let's check the entire process consisting of the molding of parts and the assembly of products in the graphical master. Component 1 and component 2 are both made using an injection molding machine, but since their shapes differ, a different injection molding machine is used for each. Product 1 is manufactured by assembling Component 1 and Component 2. Before creating the schedule, let's register the display colors of the resources in the resource Gantt chart. Let's also register the manufacturing orders to be scheduled. We will manufacture 100 pieces of Product 1 by 8 p.m. of July 11, 2016. To accomplish this, we need 100 pieces each of Component 1 and Component 2. We have the scheduler automatically perform the calculations required to manufacture these parts in just the needed quantity. Set auto-replenishment in the item table. Here, we use full built-to-order manufacturing that replenishes products on an individual manufacturing order basis as the model. In a later video, I will explain repetitive manufacturing that replenishes products in bulk in lot sizes. Now, let's perform scheduling. A schedule has been created under which parts Component 1 and Component 2 are automatically replenished to fill their respective manufacturing orders. The parts are assigned to the appropriate equipment according to their registered integrated master. Also, the production time is calculated. 100 pieces of Product 1 can thus be manufactured in a timely manner. If we change the quantity of the manufacturing order for Product 1, the production time will change according to the production quantity. By registering processes and production capacities in this way, realizable plans can be scheduled quickly. Now, let's step a little further into the world of scheduling.